Young's modulus and Shore hardness are two figures that you see all over the place in 3D printing. They're part of the specifications for a lot of industrial and professional grade 3D printing materials. So today we're going to explore what those measurements mean and how you should think about them. To explain this, we have with us Marie Herring, who's a staff research scientist here at Carbon. Marie, great to have you with us.
Hi, John. Thanks. One of the critical questions that everybody asks is, how do I determine the hardness of a material? Hardness is a very subjective term. It doesn't give you a lot of information. And so usually in additive technologies, you want to look at a more quantitative measure to compare different materials.
Cool. Let's begin with Young's modulus.
So Young's modulus is a measurement that is derived from the relationship between stress and strain. So stress is the force per unit area, and strain is the proportional deformation that can happen when stress is applied to a material. And you're really only looking at a very certain portion of the stress-strain curve. You're looking at the linear elastic region of a uniaxial deformation. The linear elastic region is the part of the stress-strain curve that's really near zero stress and strain. So right when you're just beginning to deform a material, and it has to correspond to a small reversible deformation. For Young's modulus, it's really critical that it is reversible, because if you look at deformations that are beyond that, then you can be getting into areas where you can't really compare things anymore. And a uniaxial deformation is something that's caused by forces only along one axis. So that means that we're not looking at deformations that are caused by strains along multiple axes. It has to be along one axis.
So let me just make sure I've got this right. You've got some material and you put it in an instrument that strains it. It either pulls it or it compresses it. And you're measuring the amount of stress that you have to apply in order to get a given amount of strain. Is that right?
Yeah, you're measuring the stress that's output from a given strain at a given strain rate.
And Carbon offers this incredibly wide range of 3D printing materials that have a really wide range of behaviors in terms of Young's modulus.
So kind of starting from the lowest one, you can see that the elastomeric polyurethane has a really low curve kind of at the beginning, very close to zero stress and strain. It's almost no slope. So that has a very low modulus. That's kind of in the range of, you know, 1 to 10 megapascals. Materials from there increase in rigidity. So if you had these materials in your hands, you might be able to bend them a little bit, but it wouldn't be as stretchy or as rubbery as maybe what you would think of as an elastomer. And as you can see, correspondingly, that modulus is increasing. That slope between the tensile strain and the tensile stress is increasing at those small reversible deformations. At the highest end of the scale, you can see cyanate ester, which really has a very sharp slope that goes up very quickly. And that's corresponding to a really high modulus.
So in kind of intuitive terms, as you go along this graph on the x-axis, you've got the machine and it's pulling the material apart. And the y-axis is telling you how much stress you need to apply in order to be doing that. So these materials like the elastomeric polyurethane, it's not taking a great deal of stress in order to really elongate it. Whereas the CE221, that cyanate ester material, you're having to really add a lot of stress to it.
Yeah, that's exactly right. Another key point to point out here as you're measuring stress strain curves is all of these, you have to measure at different strain rates. So for something that's softer, you pull at a faster rate, and those are defined by ASTM and ISO standards that we follow when we do all of our testing at Carbon.
Let's move on to Shore hardness. This is another thing that you see spec'd for a lot of 3D printing material.
So Shore hardness or durometer is also measuring hardness, but in a little bit of a different way. Shore hardness is applying a given force to a very specified presser foot or indenter. The depth of that indentation is read out as its durometer. As you can see from this figure, there are generally a lot of different types of presser foots, but the two types that are most commonly used are type A and type D. Typically, type A is used for softer materials, and then type D is used for harder materials.
So just intuitively, this is something where you're imagining taking a soft material, something you can deform, and sticking your thumbnail in, And the question is, how deep can you, you know, comfortably stick your thumbnail into the material, right?
That's a great analogy. If you work in different materials, you might know that as you handle them, you might think of trying to bend them or scratch them. And so shore hardness is really looking at more of, that indentation force. Like, can you dig something into it? And if so, how deep? And kind of making it standardized.
Awesome. So viewers who want to learn more about Carbon's materials can go to carbon3d.com. And if you want to learn more about additive manufacturing and 3D printing and everything you should consider as you design great products with 3D printing, just subscribe to Ask an Additive Expert on YouTube. Marie Herring is a staff research scientist at Carbon. Marie, thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you, John.